Consider a rectangular wing with an aspect ratio of 6, an induced drag factor of 0.055, and a zero lift angle of attack of negative 2 degrees. Now, at an angle of attack of 3.4 degrees, the induced drag coefficient for the wing is 0.01. So what we need to do is calculate the induced drag coefficient for a similar wing, a rectangular wing with the same airfoil section at the same angle of attack, but with an aspect ratio of 10. Now, for this problem, we are going to assume that the induced factors for drag and the lift slope, both delta and tau respectively, are going to be equal to each other. We're also going to assume that for the new wing, aspect ratio is equal to 10, and delta is equal to 0.105. So now what we can start out by doing is we can say for the same airfoil section, A naught, or the essentially lift slope for the airfoil, are going to be the same. So we'll say same airfoil section. So since we have this, A naught is the same for both. So that's going to be handy in essentially calculating the final answer. So we can start out by defining our coefficient of lift for that first wing. So CL squared is going to be equal to pi times the aspect ratio for the first wing times the coefficient of drag induced divided by 1 plus delta. And we have all the values for this, so we can essentially just plug them in. 6, 0.01, and then we'll have 1 plus 0.055, or 1.055. And then by taking the square root, we get that the coefficient of lift is equal to 0.423. So now, the next step that we can do is we can calculate the essentially the lift slope of the wing. And that is defined as dCL d alpha. That's going to be equal to A, or our lift slope of the wing. So for dCL, that is equal to 0.423. And for d alpha, what we're going to do is take our current angle of attack and subtract the angle of attack where the lift is equal to 0. So the current angle of attack is 3.4 degrees, and then we're going to subtract negative 2 degrees, which is the angle of attack where the lift is equal to 0. So this gives a value, or a lift slope of the wing, of 0.078 per degree. And we can convert this to radians to get 4.485 radian inverse. Okay, so now the next thing that we can do is we can use the relation between the lift slope of the wing and the lift slope of the airfoil. So we can essentially say that the lift slope of the wing, A, is equal to the lift slope of the airfoil, A naught, divided by 1 plus A naught, again divided by pi times aspect ratio, and then we can multiply by 1 plus tau. But here's, we said that tau, our essentially induced factor for the lift slope, that's going to be equal to delta, which is the induced factor for drag. So we essentially have all of the values to input except A naught, which we can then solve for. So we'll have 4.485 radian inverse. It's going to be equal to A naught divided by 1 plus A naught divided by pi times aspect ratio of the first wing, which is 6. And we'll multiply by 1 plus 0.055. So then we can solve for A naught to get a essentially lift curve slope of the airfoil of 5.989 radian inverse. Okay. So now the next step, now that we have A naught, because we said before that they're going to be equal for both wings, because they have the same airfoil section, we can now solve for the lift slope of the wing for the rectangular wing with aspect ratio of 10. So I know we're jumping back and forth between the two wings, but here, I'll label this A sub 10, just to try to differentiate the two. And then, so we have the same A naught, and then we're divided by 1 plus A naught divided by pi AR. Now for the 10, essentially the aspect ratio 10, and then plus 1 plus tau. So that's going to be also for 10. So remember that changed in our problem statement. So we said delta is going to be 0.105, but we're saying that delta is approximately equal to tau. So we can essentially use those two values, and then we pretty much just plug in what we have so far. So let's do that real quick. Okay, so this will give us a lift slope for the wing of the aspect ratio 10 wing equal to 4.95 per radian. And if we convert that to per degree, we get 0.086 per degree. So now we are pretty much in the home stretch. So now we can calculate the coefficient of lift for this rectangular wing with a aspect ratio of 10. So CL is going to be equal to A sub 10 times alpha minus alpha, where lift is equal to 0. So we'll essentially have 0.086 per degree. We'll have 3.4 degrees as our angle of attack, and then we'll subtract by negative 2 degrees, where lift is equal to 0 at some angle of attack. And then that'll give a coefficient of lift equal to 0.464. So now, final thing. So we have coefficient of drag induced. That is going to be equal to coefficient of lift squared divided by pi times aspect ratio times 1 plus delta. So CL is 0.464 squared. And then we'll have pi times aspect ratio of 10. And we'll have essentially 1.105. So that'll give a coefficient of drag induced equal to 0.0076. And we are done.